And it's useful because it's showing us how to make a perfect square, right? 1 squared, 1 times 1, 1, 2 squared, 2 times 2, 4. What's a common mistake that people make with exponents? Who can tell me a very common mistake? You've probably made it before. What do you think, Lorraine?
When my principle 4 squared, you would probably do 4 times 2 instead of 4 times 4.
Correct. That is a very common mistake. So you just need to remember that this tiny number tells us that we're taking 4 times 4, like 4 times itself. Okay, Xavier?
I have a new question.
Okay.
Are we going to be able to use our binders on tests?
No. But you can, like, when it comes time for this assessment, I'm going to post this up on the screen so you'll have it as a resource while you're taking it.
So you'll just, like, post it on there.
Mm-hmm. And then we give you guys extremely helpful study guides.
What about calculators?
Depends on the assessment. Right? So like on what we're going to do today is estimate values of irrational numbers. I'm not going to let you use a calculator because you could just put it into the calculator. Right?
Yeah.
But when we get to equations and things, yes, you get to use calculators.
Okay. So like most of the time?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. Okay. So we have 6 times 6, 36, and so on. Then we come to this column here that is the square roots column. And this tells us what was multiplied times itself to get that number, right? So square root of 4 is 2. Well, that's because we did 2 times 2 to make 4. Square root of 9 is 3. 3 times 3 is 9. We're going to be really using this column a lot today when we take our notes, okay? This is going to be your guide. So keep this paper out on your desk, and then you need 1, maybe 2 pieces of paper, lined paper, depending if you like to write on the back. If you're going to write on the back, 1 piece. If you don't want to write on the back, you need 2 pieces of lined paper. We are estimating irrational values today. Remember, the more accurate your notes are to what I have, the better you'll be for your quiz, for your final quiz.
Oh.
Right? Remember, I don't tell you the notes.
What? I'm going to get back to you because I'm at Walmart.
Oh, I thought she said, it says I have some stuff from her. Is there a specific thing I need to be looking for?
Oh, okay, all right. That's fair.
Because I asked her to check if you have emails from her.
That's fair. Okay, I'll take it. I'll take that as a yes. Thank you very much, Mason. Okay. Pull out a paper here for you.
Is she making a toilet paper for her at Walmart?
Yeah. She's doing 24-hour challenge.
Thank you.
does have to be 72 hours.
It never did. Mine.
Nope. I did it with the one hit Rick. And
here we go.
Hit that. Dang.
So we're just going to, the first thing we're going to do is go through the process with steps. And then you're just going to be able to use those steps for the other examples. So our first one, we're going to estimate the square root of 34. So step one is to identify the two square roots that the square root of 34 falls between. So you're going to use that pink paper, the column that says square roots. What two square roots does square root of 34 fall between? Yes. Square root of what? Is there anything closer to square root of 34? Square root of 36. So step two, now that we have those, we're going to draw a number line. To show the square roots. So this number line is going to be our helpful resource for how to estimate those values. So on the left side of my number line, I'm going to have square root of 25. And on the right, I'm going to have square root of 36. Next time it goes in the trash. Thanks. What is the square root of 25? 5. What's the square root of 36? 6. Yep. So now we have our whole number values that it's going to fall between. So we know that the square root of 34 is somewhere between 5 and 6. So then I'm going to draw a line where I think the middle would be, and I'm going to say, well, 5.5 is between square root of between 5 and 6. Right? And then I'm going to say, well, is the square root of 34 closer to square root of 36, or would the 34 be closer to the number 25? It's going to be closer to the 36. So I'm going to say, all right, it's right about here. Remember, I'm just estimating, so I know it's somewhere in here, in this half of the value. So if you had to give me an educated guess, what do you think the approximate value would be of the square root of 34? Xavier?
I'd say about probably like 5.8.
Sure. Now, you'll notice that I have these little squiggles here. Mathematically, those mean approximately, about, okay? We can't use an actual equal sign because it's not an exact value, right? We're estimating because it's one of those ugly, non-perfect squares. So then step three is to write my final answer. Square root of 34 is about 5.8. So we just estimated an irrational value. We used our perfect square chart, we used a number line, we used all of our mathematical prior knowledge. Anybody have questions about that process? Okay, do a few more examples. Make sure we really understand what's happening here. So example two, we're going to process the estimate of the square root of 136. I'm not going to write all those steps again. I don't have to do that. I'm just going to use the steps from my first example to work my way through here. So what am I going to do first? What do I have to do first? CJ?
Draw a number line.
I'm going to draw a number line. Good.
Actually,
yep. What are we going to use this number line for? Jackson?
To identify the two square roots that fall between 136.
136 falls between, right? So what's one square root lower? Xavier?
121.
Square root of 121, which happens to be 11. And then what's the higher one? Chloe? Square root of 144. So we know that this number is somewhere between 11 and 12. We're just trying to figure out exactly where is it between 11 and 12. So I'm going to draw my halfway mark. I did have students in third period say, well, how do I know then what this is? Like, how do I know what the square root is of about 11.5? Can anybody tell me how would I figure out what that would be?
I know.
How? Yes.
Because it's in between like 11 and 12, and that's like easy. 11.5 because it's in the middle.
Right. So, but how would I know what the square root value is of about 11.5? Silas, what are you thinking?
44 minus 21.
Yeah, so 144 minus 121 is going to be 23, right?
So 123.
Well, then I'm going to have to take half of that because it's halfway between. So what's half of 23?
I know.
It's about half of 23. Yes?
It's like 23 and 11.15.
Okay. 11.5. So I'm going to add 11.5 to this. And that'll get me halfway between here and here. Right? Well, that'd be 21.
10.5?
No, 11.5 is 23.
Yeah.
I meant like 10.15.
Yeah, we're going to go with 11.5. So this is about
32.5. Oh. Silly you.
Right? So I took half between 121 and 144. So now I know for sure that 136 belongs on this side, right? Because it's bigger than the 132.5, less than the 144. So I'm going to put that right about here. So what do we think it would be? What estimate would you give that? It's bigger than 11.5. Right? What do you think that good estimate would be there? Gabriel, what do you think? Perfect. We'll take it. About 11.7. So my final answer square root of 136 is about 11.7. Great. Now if it came time for a quiz and you were like, oh my gosh, what if she's looking for 11.8? Guys, I am not that picky when we're estimating values. If you know it's somewhere in between these two, the 11.5 and 12, I'm pretty happy with that.
It's in like the range.
Yeah, I'm a very reasonable person. Okay, I'm a fair grader when it comes to math, right? Okay, let's do another one together. Now I'm on my second page because like I said, I don't like to use the back, but that's up to you. You guys are gonna do this one by yourself. So I would have drawn a number line to show that it's going to be between the square root of 4 and the square root of
9.
Right? So then I know that it's going to be somewhere between 2 and 3. And four is, five is very close to four. So I would have put square root of 5, and I would have said maybe about 2.1 or 2.2, because it's so close. How'd you guys do? 2.1, 2.2? So square root of 5 is about 2.1. Again, if you had 2.2, I'm okay with that. There's not a whole lot happening between 4 and 9, so I would have accepted that as well. Yes, sir. That's a little high, but I probably would still count it. Yep, a little high. Okay, now we have a couple. How many people? Thumbs up, thumbs down. How'd you guys do on that one? Pretty good? Thumbs down. What'd you have?
Why do you get it? I just don't get it.
So which part? Is it like choosing the boundary numbers?
Yeah.
Okay. So if you look on your pink sheet, right? So if we look here at this pink sheet, so I'm looking for the square root that is lower and the square root that is higher than square root of 5. So this is going to be lower and this is going to be higher. So those become my boundaries because square root of 5 is going to be somewhere in between those. So like if I was looking for square root of 87, where would that fall between? Yep. So I'm looking at these numbers to decide where was this. Where's the square root that I'm trying to estimate? Where does it fall in this? Yep. Great question. Yes, Lorraine. So if I wanted to know what this would be, so there's 5 between here, right? There's 5 numbers between the 4 and the 9. So what's half of 5? 2.5. So I would add 2.5 to that. So then if this is 2.5 away and this is 2.5 away. And again, it's just an estimate. So you take half of the difference between the two numbers. So if it was 20 apart, what would my middle value be? Like how much would I add to get the middle value? Yep, exactly. So the middle number isn't 10, it's this lower one plus 10, or the higher value minus 10, if that's what it is, okay? All right, next question we're gonna do. This one's a little bit different, but don't let it scare you. Three plus the square root of 23. You're gonna be fine. What's 6 plus 3? 9. So you can add 3 to a number, right? So we're gonna do the exact same process, except we have one extra step, adding that 3. Yep. So we're gonna ignore the plus 3 until the end. So we're going to do the exact same steps we've been doing. We're going to focus on that square root of 23. So I'm going to draw my number line. Gemma, what are my boundary numbers going to be? I'm sorry, Kara, what are my boundary numbers going to be? I'm looking right where Gemma sits for the class, the different class. Kara, what are my boundary numbers going to be? 16. So square root of 16 is 4. Square root of 25 is 5. 4.5 is somewhere in the middle. Lorraine, if I wanted to come figure out what this would be, tell me how I would do that.
Well,
great, because there's 9 in between these, right? So I'm going to add 4.5 to this. This would be about 20.5. So where's that square root of 23 going to be? Jackson?
Would it be 4.7?
It's going to be about 4.7. So square root of 23 is going to be about 4.7. If you had 4.8, that works as well. So now I have to add 3 to this number. So I'm going to do 3 plus about 4.7. And what am I going to get here for my final estimate? Yes, sir.
7.7.
About 7.7. So 3 plus the square root of 23 is about 7.7. That's my final answer. I always put a border around my final answers so there's no mystery on my paper. If someone is looking at mine to figure out, well, where does this problem stop? You can't miss it, right? Okay, you guys are gonna do the last one by yourself. You've done a great job. Square root of 51 minus 5. So first we find the square root of 51, and then we subtract the 5.
Thank you.
2.1. I saw some people with about 2.2, about 2.3. I would accept those. The main thing is that you know to find the square root first and then subtract 5. Okay, that's really what I'm looking for. Okay, so what I need you to do right now, we're going to put these in our binder. You're going to put the pink paper behind the repeating decimal practice that we did. So your pink paper that has the charts on it goes behind the repeating decimal. And then the notes go behind the pink paper. Is anybody still copying notes? Okay. And then, of course, our last step is to fill in our table of contents. So something I decided to do with third period, just to make it a little bit easier to clarify. So under August 8th, we took notes. And then foldable practice handout, I wrote pink here. And then for these last two, make sure you put notes. So if you don't have notes next to the word classify numbers, please put the word notes. And then all of these should be on your table of contents. Okay? We're keeping track of everything that's in there. I'm really worried about your math binder situation. Are you starting to get worried about it a little?
Nope.
Okay.